Exercise number 3.4, question number 8. In the given figure, triangle ABC, we are talking about this triangle ABC, which is there on your screen. Segment AD and segment BE are altitudes. So AD and BE are altitudes means they are perpendicular, and AE equal with BD. So this is given information and very important information. AE is equal with BD. Prove that segment AD is congruent. This is congruent sign, which is not appear properly due to copy paste. This is like this. Congruent with segment BE, AD and BE, these two segments are congruent, that we need to prove. So first I'll write my given information. What is given? Given that AD is perpendicular on BC, altitudes means perpendicular, and BE is perpendicular on AC. So this is given information. Besides, AE, length AE is equal with BD. This is also given. So this is AE, this AE equal with BD. Then question says, prove that. So here I'll take two proof, and you will write what is required to be proved. We need to prove that segment AD is congruent with segment BE. So this is our requirement to be proved. Better? Okay, next is proof. So AD and BE, these two are actually corresponding sides of two triangles in the given figure. I'll take those two triangles and I'll try to prove those two triangles as congruent. Once they will become congruent, so we can say that AD and BE are also congruent since they are corresponding sides of congruent triangle. So this way we can prove this. Now those two triangles are in triangle ABD. And triangle, so first triangle which I am taking ABD, and other triangle which we can take is triangle BAE. So in these two triangles, I can say angle ADB. In this triangle, angle ADB is actually equal with angle BEA. In this triangle. So basically we are talking about these two angles, and each is of 90 degree, because AD perpendicular on BC and BE perpendicular on AC. So they make 90 degree angle. So here you can mention each is a right angle. Same way, I can take segment AB which is hypotenuse in both the cases. So I can take hypotenuse AB in this triangle which is equal with hypotenuse AB in other triangle. So this is common side in both the triangle. So we have two corresponding components as equal and congruent. We need one more to prove that the given these two triangles are congruent. So the third can be taken as side AE or side BD in this triangle. In first triangle, it is side BD, which is congruent with this side. BD is congruent with side AE in other triangle. And this is actually already given. So here you can write given information. This is given proof. Now we have three components, corresponding components as congruent. So on the basis of these three, we can say triangle ABD is congruent with triangle BAE. If these two triangles are congruent, so we need to mention which test we are using here. So it is hypotenuse side test, because one angle, one pair of corresponding angle is right angle, and hypotenuse is common in both the triangle. So this is called hypotenuse side test. Hypotenuse side test. If these two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding sides will also equal and congruent, like AD and BE. These are two corresponding sides of two congruent triangles. So here I can say, therefore, segment AD is congruent with segment BE. And here you can mention corresponding sides of congruent triangle. So this is your proof, and this way we can prove AD is congruent with BE in the given question. Hope it is clear to everybody. ABC is similar with triangle PQR, then if these two triangles are similar, then they must have corresponding side in same ratio, like this. AB should be upon PQ should be equal with BC upon QR, and should be equal with AC upon PR. So all three ratios of corresponding sides should be equal if they are similar triangle. What about their angles? So corresponding angles will also equal and congruent. For example, angle A will be congruent with angle P, angle B should be congruent as angle Q, and angle C should be same and equal as angle R. So this is basic property of similar triangle that all three angles, corresponding angles, will be equal and ratio of their corresponding sides will be equal. For example, if this angle A is of 40 degree, then this angle P should be of 40 degree. If B is of 70 degree, then this Q should be of 70 degree if they are similar. If this C is of 70, then this R should be of 70. Like this. So this is all about similar triangle, and test of similarity we have already discussed, which are the various tests to prove that two triangles are similar. Okay. This is question number 2. In triangle XYZ, length of XY, YZ, XZ are already given. If triangle XYZ is similar with triangle PQR, this is given. So you are given that triangle XYZ is similar with triangle PQR. So this is already given. On the basis of this information, I can say XY upon PQ is equal with YZ upon QR is equal with XZ upon PR. So these are corresponding sides, ratio of their corresponding sides, which are equal because they are corresponding sides of similar triangle. So their ratio should be equal. Now XY is already given, which is 4. Look at this, XY is 4 centimeter. So on the place of XY we can take 4 upon PQ. PQ is also given, 8 centimeter. So here I can take 8. Then YZ, this is YZ, and YZ is 6 centimeter. So here I can take 6 centimeter. Upon QR we need to calculate, find the remaining sides of the triangle PQR. So triangle PQR has 3 sides. One is PQ, QR and PR. These are 3 sides of this triangle, out of which PQ is given, which is 8 centimeter. So remaining sides are QR and PR. These two we are going to calculate. So this is QR and this is PR. Is equal with XZ. XZ is already given as 5 centimeter. So here I'll take 5 centimeter upon PR will remain as PR because we don't have PR. PR we need to calculate. These three ratios, 4 by 8, 6 by QR, 5 by PR. These three ratios are equal. If they are equal, so any two of them can be taken as equal. So here I can say 4 by 8 is equal with 6 upon QR. Now we can cross multiply them. So 4 into QR is equal with 8 into 6. So this QR on its place, 8 into 6 on its place, this 4 can be sent to the right hand side, will divide. So 4 ones are 4 twos are. So this way we can find out QR as 12 centimeter. This is length of QR. Now we need to find out length of QR as well as PR. So PR can be taken can be calculated by taking first and third ratio, because all three ratios are equal. So any two of them can be taken as equal. So 4 by 8 is also equal as 5 by PR. So 5 by PR, so you can cross multiply 4 into PR is equal with 8 into 5. So PR is actually 8 into 5 by 4. So this way PR 4 2s are 2 5s are 10 centimeter. So length of QR is 12, length of PR is 10. And this is the procedure to calculate remaining two sides of the triangle PQR. Hope it is clear to everybody.